So this topic, I think a lot of people are going to inevitably run into in this, if you're into this fitness, lifting, this whole thing. And fit shaming, what it is basically people almost like looking down on you or like kind of shaming you for being into this whole fitness and health lifestyle. And for one, I'm not trying to make it come off like I'm complaining here. I feel like in today's world, not to get like political and stuff, but I feel like a lot of people are getting kind of caught into this competitive victimism to where they're almost trying to see who's more of a victim instead of just like taking control of their life and trying to improve. Like, I understand. I was dealt a really good hand. I really was. And I'm really grateful for that. But man, sometimes I feel like everybody's just trying to see who's a bigger victim in this world. So I'm not saying that fit people are victims or anything like that. Because if you're into this fitness thing and you're lifting and doing that sort of thing, then you're not a victim. You're very lucky. So I don't want it to come off like I'm saying I'm a victim or I'm saying that fit people are victims or anything like that. But I do see where there is some of this fit shaming going on to where some people can get kind of looked down on you for being into this fitness thing and for making healthy choices and things like that. For example, I know sometimes if I'm making healthy choices at restaurants, for example, I've gone to restaurants where I've just gotten like a baked potato instead of French fries, or I've ordered, you know, vegetables without butter and stuff like that. And it's the people I'm with like have been like, oh, you're so healthy. And like almost with like an undertone, like little backhand at like, there's something wrong with that. And I don't know, like, I feel like that kind of sucks because it can keep people from wanting to get in this whole fitness thing that I think can be really beneficial for people. And I
don't want it to sound like I'm complaining here, but sometimes I also feel guilty for doing this fitness thing. For example, when I was recently home over winter break, I almost felt guilty about telling my family, who's really not into lifting, not into fitness a whole lot, like they stay active and do those things, but not quite to the extent I am. And I almost felt guilty about over the holiday telling them, hey, I'm gonna go lift weights, because I didn't want to make them feel bad for not going to the gym and lifting weights. Another example of this is on social media. Like, I enjoy the process of taking photos and stuff, but I don't necessarily enjoy posting photos of myself on social media, because like, especially if it's a shirtless pic or a picture where my arms look pretty good or something like that. Does it stroke my ego a little bit? Yeah, of course it does. Of course it feels good to get a few likes and to have people comment on your video saying you make progress. Of course that feels good. But I know that some people are going to be comparing themselves to those pictures, and that some people that follow me are high school friends that don't lift weights, that aren't into this fitness thing. And I don't want them to think that there's anything wrong with that. Do I think that there's incredible benefits to doing this fitness thing and lifting weights and that sort of thing? Of course I do. But if you're staying generally healthy, you're moderately active, you're happy with the way you look, but maybe you're not like trying to build as much muscle as you can or to be really lean and have abs, but you're just pretty good with being generally healthy and active and doing that sort of thing, that's great. There's a whole bunch of things in this life other than this fitness thing. And if you're generally healthy and doing that sort of thing, then great, more power to you. That's not my personal goals. I enjoy chasing down, building more muscle and improving myself physically as well as other aspects of my life. But I don't want people to feel like, I don't know, more insecure about themselves if they're trying to compare to a photo of myself on Instagram that's like my 100% top picture. And I'm kind of caught to where, not caught, like, this is a first world problem, worrying about some of this stuff. And again, I don't want to sound like I'm complaining or like I'm a victim of any of this stuff, because I'm incredibly grateful for where I am. But I am in a situation to where I feel like I don't necessarily want to post these pictures and like have people compare themselves and to make it look like I think I'm something special because I lift some weights. But I'm also a freaking good coach. I know what I'm doing. I know how to get my clients results. And if I don't post on, you know, the social medias and stuff like that, then how's anybody gonna get exposed to what I know and my content? And the reality of the matter is it matters how you look. Someone doesn't want to take advice from someone that doesn't at least somewhat look the part. So if I feel like if I don't post some pictures where at least I somewhat look the part, then who's really gonna care what I have to say? And that's not to say that you shouldn't take advice from people that don't necessarily look amazing. That's not what I'm saying at all. But I am saying there's something to be said for at least looking somewhat like you've gone through the process, you know? And what's this have to do with fit shame? Well, I feel like even on social media, like in real life, you talk to your friends and they see you have like a fitness account, you might catch some hell for that. You might get some shit, or even behind your back, it could be, oh, he has a fitness account. He's super into that. You know, almost like it's a bad thing. And, you know, I enjoy when my friends give you some shit like that. Like, if they're close friends and I know that they're mean and well by it, I'm fine with it. I could give them shit right back. I'm cool with it. But, like, I do think that there's probably some people that are kind of bad-mouthing people behind their back because they're, like, more into the fitness thing. And I don't know. It just kind of sucks because I think that getting into lifting and this whole fitness thing is something that can change your entire life for the better. And if it's kind of stigmatized as something that's bad if you choose healthier options at a meal, or that you like to lift weights for 6 to 10 hours a week, that there's something wrong with that, you know? So what do you do when people start doing this? Well, I think you can kind of solve this by
make fun of yourself as kind of the fit person, the person that's always being healthy. Like if you're gonna order the baked potato and the veggies instead of the French fries and a dessert or something like that, you could play it off as, okay guys, you guys know me, you know I'm gonna be ordering the baked potato and the French fries, and just kind of make it a little bit more jokey and like lighthearted rather than like you're taking like offense to someone saying something like that.
I know I made the mistake in the past. It was a while ago. It was at like a Christmas or a holiday or something like that, and my grandma made like sweet potato just for me because she thought it was like so much better than white potatoes, and was like, oh, you're into that health stuff, you can't have white potatoes. And I remember in the moment getting a little bit salty and saying something along the lines of, oh, I can have whatever I want, you know, something along those lines. That was a while ago, and I it still kind of gets to me that I said that. And just because I feel like if I would have just played it off, kind of just laughed it off and was like, oh yeah, you know me, I need to have that sweet potato, and just did something like that, then it would have been better. But I feel like I just took too much like offense to that, saying that I can't eat certain things and things like that. So try not to take offense to it. Usually if someone is, you know, giving you a hard time about this stuff, they probably don't mean it like personally against you or anything like that.
So overall, fit shaming, I do think it's a thing. I do think that there's some people that just kind of look down on people that are kind of really into making healthier choices and things like that. And I do think that there's a balance to where you still have to live your life and do this fitness thing. And I think that that's totally practical for a lot of people to do. And I don't think that, you know, fit people are like super victims to this sort of thing or anything like that. No, I think it's largely just people that, you know, they might feel a little more, and I don't want to say that everybody else is insecure if they aren't into this fitness thing. I'm not saying that, but I do think that if someone is really bad mouthing someone for being like into this fitness thing and making healthy choices and really like doing the whole eye roll thing when they order something that's healthy at a restaurant, then it's probably more so something that they're uncomfortable with about themselves rather than that there's something that you're inherently doing wrong. So hopefully by doing those things can kind of help your way around this thing, because at some point you're probably gonna come across some of these backhanded comments and things like that. And you know, I think the pros of getting into this fitness thing and what it can do to your entire life is definitely worth being a little fit shamed every once in a while. So I hope you enjoyed this video.
Let me know how you liked the formatting of this video. If you liked how I kind of went back and forth between different cameras and different like in-studio shots and vlog style shots. If you like that, if there's any topics you want me to cover, just let me know and I'd be happy to help you out. Make sure to consider subscribing, dropping this bad boy a like, screenshot it, put it on your story, and I'll see you in that next one.